those of you who are female, roughly my age, sup. Now, when I was younger, I did something that I'm sure all of us have done, or maybe just me. I'm talking about fake girlfriend. When I was younger, I had a friend who went outside of school, and I told everyone she was my girlfriend. For the sake of storytelling, we'll call her Sarah. Now, one of my friends at school told me, hey, I think I know Sarah. I'm gonna go talk to her about how you're telling everybody how you two are dating. And I said, no, please, do not do that. I know we're dating, she totally knows we're dating, and everybody who I told about this knows that we're dating. So that's enough people. But she comes to school the next day, telling me, Robbie, Sarah told me that you two weren't dating. And so ends my first relationship. I was 8, I probably should have known better. It's whatever. A year later, my family and I head on vacation to a resort, and my parents drop us off at this daycare area. And now that I look back on that whole aspect of it, they probably dropped us off there because they didn't want the kids walking in on them wrestling. But anyway, I met this girl there, and we got along super well. And we end up talking a lot, making friends, and we have an agreement to meet up the next day at the water park. So we do, and we get on the lazy river, and I face her in like a two-person inner tube. And I look at her, and I start thinking, I really like this girl. So I go, hey, you and me, we're pretty awesome together. And she goes, what does that mean? Now, I do not know. She is clearly not picking up what I am putting down, and I am not picking up what I am putting down. So now I'm in panic mode. So I go, ah! I jump off the inner tube and swim away as fast as I can. I never see her again. Clearly, by the age of 9, I was a master with my words. Later on, I end up switching schools and coming here to Glen Elk, and there's this girl who I ask out many a times. Maybe 10, maybe 20, maybe 30 times. And one time, she finally says yes. And I was like, sweet, I'm so happy about this. I was so happy, in fact, that every time I saw her, I had to make sure that we were still going out. I see her in the hallway, I go, hey, we're still going out, right?
Yeah.
I see her after school, and I'm like, hey, we're still going out, right? And she's like, yeah, totally. The day before the dance, she comes up to me and goes, hey, listen, Robbie, it's definitely you, and it's definitely not me. She did not come to the dance, and she did not come to any of the other dances. I'm assuming the next ones were because other guys asked her out, probably, maybe, definitely not. Anyway, I go to high school, and there's this girl who I start like trying to flirt with, slide into her DMs for those older people, that means direct messages, like, get in there! Anyway, I follow her around and try to help her out with her guy problems. But that backfires on me, because I help her out with her guy problems, and then she gets together with the guy who she had guy problems with, and then she ends up breaking up with that guy, has more guy problems, and then I help her get together with another guy. And that repeats the cycle with guys that aren't me. Anyway, one day, she comes up to me and she goes, hey Robbie, you're a really good friend to me. You're like a dog. She gives me a dog collar. A real dog collar. I am serious. I cannot be more specific when I tell you that she actually gave me a dog collar and expected me to put it on. A couple days after this, I see her on the stairwell and I talk to her and she goes, hey Robbie, if you were taller, I would probably date you. And that was it for me. It was all over. I come home from school and my parents see me and they're like, hey Robbie, how's your day? And I point at them and I go, you! You are the reason why I'm so small, insignificant, and can't please a woman! Now my dad looks at me and he's very confused and his feelings are hurt for whatever reason about what I just said. And he goes, Robbie, what are you talking about? And I'm like, Mom and Dad, you're the reason I'm so short. Thank you very much. I'm Robbie Robinson. Have a good night!